Multiplayer shooter maps. Let me know just by me saying that what maps come to your mind. And multiplayer shooters have been around for decades now, and there have been tons of great maps that you can play over and over again and honestly never get bored. But what maps rise above the rest? What are the greatest from any given game? What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and today we're gonna be checking out a list of 10 of the best multiplayer shooter maps ever made in video game history. And be sure to let me know what your favorite map of all time in a multiplayer game is, and what that multiplayer game is. Drop a like and let's get into it. Kicking off our list at number 10 is Gridlock in Gears of War. This is a fan favorite map from the third-person shooter series Gears of War. Gridlock debuted in the original game, and it's since returned in every single main installment since then. I mean, people love it. It greatly complements the mechanics of Gears of War, and in case you didn't know, there are no custom loadouts in Gears. I mean, you have to fight for power positions, and weapons are laid out on the map, making certain locations extremely contested. Gridlock is perhaps the best example of this. It's a very large map, and in the dead center, there is a section of high ground that spawns a sniper rifle, and a section of low ground that spawns multiple explosive weapons. And both of these areas are a huge threat to each other due to how quickly they can take each other out. So if you go up top, you can grab that sniper and take out the people rushing the explosives. But if you go down below, well, you can grab the explosives and flush out those dirty snipers. Gridlock is an excellent map for just about every mode in Gears, and it's the perfect way to kick off this list. At number 9, we have a rather peculiar name of a map. It's Q3DM17 in Quake 3 Arena. Now, the Quake franchise has a massive influence on first-person shooters, and perhaps the most famous map from the series was the one I just said. It's also known as the Longest Yard, okay? It was a medium-sized map with a ton of open space and verticality, which allows for tons of fights and very little downtime. So, if you're on this map, you were fighting. That's the end of the story. No hiding, no retreating, no taking cover, just fighting, and it was amazing. This map also has one of the most infamous sniper patches in gaming history, as there is a perch at the top of the map that is super hard to get to. Well, it's hard to get there before anybody else, but if you pull it off, you can own the battlefield for pretty much as long as you want to if you knew what you were doing, and it's definitely the most legendary Quake multiplayer map of all time. Let's stick with the Unreal Engine at number 8, and let's go with Facing Worlds in Unreal Tournament. Speaking of arena shooters, man, Unreal Tournament used to be the best. This was a game that really put Epic Games on the map and really helped blow up the popularity of multiplayer shooters. Perhaps the best place to experience Unreal Tournament was on the map Facing Worlds. This is a wide open map, and it was one of the best Capture the Flag maps ever made, as you really had to work with your team in order to get the job done and make sure you didn't get turned into a bloody pile of body parts, carcass parts out in space. Now, nowadays, it seems game developers are trying to get more and more outlandish with the design of their multiplayer maps, or if they're like COD, where it's just everything is three lanes and you're supposed to be impressed by the visuals. But if you go back to the arena shooter days, map design, well, it was much more interesting. There was a lot more emphasis on getting creative with your movement and routes, as you needed to know where you were going, as well as reliance on your gun skill. And I hope, with the popularity of games like Doom and Overwatch right now, that future multiplayer shooters get a little more creative with their map design. At number 7, King's Row in Overwatch. Map design for a game like Overwatch is very tough due to the nature of the mechanics and the fact that everything has to be heavily objective based. But if I had to pick one in the game, one that does better than others, I think it would be King's Row. And the Overwatch community largely agrees, because a while back Blizzard did a survey to see what fans thought of the maps, and King's Row was far and away the best received. Now, it's a hybrid map. It starts off as a zone capture before becoming a payload escort, and both of these sections are very well designed and highly competitive. Just about every character and playstyle can shine here, and that is largely due to the fact that King's Row was actually the very first map that Blizzard designed for Overwatch's development. They wanted to make sure that every character could perform there and shine there. Now, the best defensive spawns can be a little bit of a pain, but it is still considered by many to be the best map in Overwatch history, and it's definitely deserving of a spot on today's list. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 6, we have Arica Harbor in Battlefield Bad Company 2. Now, everybody has their own favorite Battlefield game, but a lot of people to this day still consider BC2 to be the best. And much of that is thanks to the excellent map design. Bad Company 2 was the first Battlefield game to really go crazy with the destructibility of the maps, and perhaps the best game, the best map in the game was Arica Harbor. It was a very hectic map with tons of combat in just about every area, and it was in the rotation for Rush, Conquest, and Squad Deathmatch. Harbor really showed off the best aspects of Bad Company 2, and I know it's not as popular as the other ones on this list, but it was good. Cracking into the top 5, and some people are going to give me hate for not putting this at number 1, but just hear me out. Nuketown, Call of Duty. You knew it was going to be on here somewhere, and it's probably the most recognizable multiplayer shooter map ever made due to its insane popularity not only in COD, but also in other games, since many people like to remake it. Nuketown debuted in 2010 in the original Black Ops, and has since returned in every single Black Ops game to date, and is always one of the most played maps in whatever game it appears in. It's extremely fast-paced, it's extremely hectic, but it is just sophisticated enough for you to establish a game flow, and this makes it very intense for objective matches. Now, it's also a camper's paradise, I know, due to how easy it is to flush out choke points, but it's insanely popular, and it is deserving of a spot on this list. So, what is your favorite version of Nuketown? At number 4, we have Battle Creek in the original Halo. Now, the original Halo had some amazing maps, and Battle Creek is one of my personal favorites. Now, the first Halo game it had a lot of wide, big open maps to allow for vehicle combat. Battle Creek was one of the go-to maps where you and your buddies wanted something fast-paced. It was pretty small in standards back then, and there were teleporters on each side that immediately zipped you over to the opposite side to allow for quick flanks and cheesy plays when you were playing Capture the Flag and Assault. The map also had some pretty insane areas of high ground that snipers could make use of as well, as power-up located on the low ground and in the dead center of the map so people could go fight for them. It may not be the most famous map in Halo history. It is one of my favorites, and I think it's one of the best in the entire series, and that's why I put it at number 4. Let's go back to Call of Duty at number 3. Rust. Man, Rust. This one may surprise you guys due to how highly I placed it, but I think Rust is deserving of number 3 spot because it had such an impact on the online gaming scene as a whole, as well as the COD scene. Nowadays, it's pretty common to see people challenging each other in 1v1s in order to settle some beef and see who's better, right? And part of the reason why that practice became so commonplace in the multiplayer shooter community, well, Modern Warfare 2 and Rust. Rust became the number one place for people to settle their video game beef with each other, and if you go into Modern Warfare 2 today, I guarantee you will eventually be challenged by someone to a 1v1 on Rust. Plus, on top of its significance to the shooter scene, Rust is just fun. I mean, its chaotic nature, it's crazy. It's a strangely good map flow, maybe? I don't know. How many 1v1s have you played on Rust? How many did you win? How many did you lose? At number 2, we're going to go with Dust 2. In Counter-Strike, this is one of the original Counter-Strike maps, and it has since become an icon of the FPS genre as a whole due to how much it is still played to this day. It has appeared in every single Counter-Strike game, and in CSGO, it even has dedicated playlists for people to only play that one map because it's that good and people love it that much. Dust 2 is extremely well-balanced as a map, and it was designed to be as symmetrical as possible, and they pulled it off. Every mode you think of plays well on the map, and just like Nuketown, it has been recreated by fans in countless other multiplayer shooters due to how well it plays with pretty much everything. Now, some people don't believe Dust 2 is the best Counter-Strike map ever made, but I'm going to give it the number 2 spot on the day. I'm going to give it the number 2 spot. I mean, its impact and its significance to the multiplayer shooter scene as a whole is enough for me. And at number 1 today, for me, is Blood Gulch in Halo. This is a legendary map, and it's been brought back so many times throughout the series. Blood Gulch is a very simple and very large map, and it takes place in a wide open field of grass with a few patches of high ground up on the sides and a base on each far end. Blood Gulch is also full of vehicles for traversing it quickly, making team coordination a must in modes like Capture the Flag. In fact, I would even go as far to say that Blood Gulch is the single greatest Capture the Flag map in video game history. Prove me wrong. Its massive size makes vehicles and communication essential due to how quickly you can get deleted if you just try to run around on your own. But this also led to people going for crazy snipes from across the map and awesome vehicle plays. Plus, due to its simplicity, people have done amazing things with Blood Gulch in the custom matches and in the Forge mode, giving it almost endless replayability factors. In my opinion, it's the greatest multiplayer shooter map of all time. There you go, guys. That is my list for the 10 best multiplayer shooter maps of all time. That is a hard list to do because there's plenty of maps that didn't make it. Let me know one map that was deserving of this list that didn't make it. If you guys enjoyed it, drop a like, subscribe, turn on those notifications, and I'll see you soon.